we're going to talk about my favorite subject. What's that? What'd you just say? Enemas? Ha! That's right! You read my mind! We're going to talk about enemas. Okay, in all seriousness, enemas are really a great way to detox if you are dealing with different types of autoimmune conditions and, of course, Lyme disease. And there are two different main types of enemas that I like to do, and I actually continue doing these enemas. So one is a coffee enema, and the other one is a probiotic enema. And one helps detoxify you, and the other one helps repair your gut by implanting probiotics. They're both retention enemas, meaning that once you put them up in there, you are going to retain them for a little while. So I get a lot of questions of people asking me how to do enemas, and I'm going to quickly tell you the best practices for doing both. So the first thing is, you go to Walgreens, you beat back all of your fear of people seeing you in line with one of these. So, a fleet enema. You go, and if you're international and you're not in the United States, it might not be called a fleet, but basically you want one of these disposable bottles. It's the 8 ounce, almost the 8 ounce bottle, and that's the one that you want to get. This is only a few bucks, very cheap, but really what you want is this bottle that you can use over and over again. And of course, you don't want the bottle to break down, so when you're done using it, you can just wash it out, rinse it out with soap and light warm water. That's what I do. And for a coffee enema, I use French press. I know, it's very European of me to use a French press, but I don't drink coffee a lot, and I find that this is a very easy method to do a coffee enema with. And of course, because you can just pour it like that. But if you have drip method, you can use drip, that's fine. If you want to make the strongest coffee enema possible, what you do is the double boil method. So basically, you put your couple scoops of coffee into maybe about 15 ounces of water, knowing that the steam is going to rise and you're going to be left over, you're going to be left with less water. So about maybe 15 ounces, because you want enough to fill up, and you let it boil, then you let it cool down, and then you let it boil again. And that is the best way to extract what the goodies from the coffee. So the goodies that we're talking about is the palmitic acid, and that is a fatty acid in coffee, and that is a compound in coffee that stimulates the glutathione S transferases, stick with me, enzyme, and that enzyme increases up to 600%. For all of you who are needing glutathione, and you know who you are, and the truth is most people do need that antioxidant, this is a great way to help your body along. And it's cheap, and what you need to do is, once you get your coffee set, you fill up your enema, you put it up there, which is not a big deal as you think it is. Literally, I can do this in about 2 seconds. So at some point you'll be able to do that too. And you go and lay down for about 20-25 minutes, and that's it. And then you can get up and expel it. And that's how you do coffee enemas. Ta-da! Okay. So that's the coffee enema. So let's talk about the probiotic enema. So I love probiotic enemas. It is absolutely the best way to get the healthy flora, the good guys, to fight against the bad guys, which is basically the overgrowth that happens in your intestines, whether it be fungus or if it's just bad bacteria. And it happens to a lot of people, actually. So if you're one of these people that have taken a lot of antibiotics, obviously this is something that you need to take very seriously. If you're someone who hasn't taken a lot of antibiotics, but you have a sick gut, and there's a lot of ways of knowing that you have a sick gut. One of the ways that I knew that I had a really sick gut was the fact that I felt really weak in my solar plexus area, and I talk about it in the book, The Tick Slayer, that I wrote. So I really had like a very general weakness in my solar plexus, and that makes sense because it's like a bundle of nerves there, and all those nerves are connected to all the parts of your intestines. And if there's a weakness there, there's a problem there. And the way that I got over it was literally doing probiotic enemas. I can't even remember how I found out about probiotic enemas. I think it was back in 2005 and nobody was really talking about it. I think I found it in some obscure place, and it may have been just the idea of coffee enemas and then doing something else. Like, what else can I put up there? So, I know you can put wheatgrass up there if you need to alkalinize your digestive tract a little bit more. So, you can drink wheatgrass and take your wheatgrass two different ways, just like your coffee. And I know that you can do chamomile tea enemas that are supposed to be really soothing for your digestive tract. And the flora enemas are very interesting, so I'll tell you the short way to do it. Basically, you get one of these bottles, you fill it up I do about 2 to 3 ounces, and the reason why is because you need to have this up in there for a good 40, 45 minutes. And the reason why is because what you're trying to do is you're trying to get the good guys up into the colon, and when they get up into the colon, they start becoming systemic and growing, and they can make their way up to the large intestines. And so when you introduce them that way, you're completely bypassing the digestive tract. There's no bile to deal with. It is just literally a straight shot. And if you give yourself time, so you insert this and then you lay down for a good 40, 45 minutes and just relax. Often this water gets completely absorbed and you don't even need to go to the bathroom afterwards. But the water obviously is a carrier, so something to think about. So this is what I do. I just do a couple ounces, not even everything. I use distilled water. I never use tap water. You can use distilled water, or if you have a really good filtration system that filters all the microorganisms and chlorine and metal out, then that's what you need to do. FloraFix is my brand. It's made to order, so everything's like really fresh, and that's really important when you deal with probiotics. You do never want to get stuff that's been sitting on the shelf ever, because it's dead. So the stuff is very live. Sometimes it's really not about how much is in a capsule, although this has 5 billion, which is great, but it's really about how you introduce it. Because if you take 5 billion up this way instead of this way, then this 5 billion can easily become a trillion. That's what happens when you put it up this way. So you'll have to get over your fear for people who have terrible digestive issues. Especially you guys, it's not even a big deal. Just do it. So what I do is I take 4 to 5 of these because I want them to be really, really strong. Oh, dadgummit! All right, just ignore that one. Okay, that's fine. It won't go. Once I put the cap on, it won't be a big deal. But you basically just open up these caps and break open everything, and you put it in there. Now, my kind. The reason why I like, I mean, there's a number of reasons. Not only is it fresh, but there's also the issue of having so many different strands that are in there, and that's really important. So don't think that you can just go eat yogurt and everything is going to be fine in your stomach. Often yogurt only has a few different types of strands of good probiotics. You need a lot, okay? You need a lot of different strands because they all do their different jobs, and that's important. Now you're probably wondering why it's all purple in there. It's purple in there because that's actually blueberry extract. And the blueberry is really good because what it does is it helps the terrain for the flora to flourish. And that's why the blueberry's in there. That's the only reason why it's in there. So I do 4 or 5 of these. And then I just put the cap back on and I shake it up. Shake it up. And now you're ready. And that's it. So you put it up in there and you go lay down for 40, 45 minutes and you've just done a really great health treatment that is relatively simple, painless, and very affordable. All right. Hope you enjoyed the video. Share it with your friends. And all the best in your recovery. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm...